and pray. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts. Thank you, Jehovah, because you've gathered us here. You have gathered us here. We are your guests this morning. You are our host. As we sit down, O God, to speak, to hear from you, we pray that, God, you are going to speak to us. Use me as your vessel this morning. As I minister to your people, O God, I pray that you're going to anoint my tongue, so that, Jehovah, Father, whatever I'm going to say, it shall be well with us, O God. Whatever I'm going to say, O God, it shall be for the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Good morning. Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana
asifiwe. Amen. I'm Josephine Karanja. Na sijui Karanja ameenda wapi. Alikuwa aende mahali. And
thank you. Saying I'm Josephine Karanja. Karanja is the vicar here. I'm grateful this morning because of what God has done unto us. We thank him for this far. It has been long since we were here. I think most of you saw me last in February. When I had all my clan here, I had a small baby by then. Sahia kuwania. Bwana asifiwe. Tumewaacha kwa nyumba ukafika huko. And we thank God because he has been on our side and we have seen him. It had been a great time seeking God for those 6 months. We couldn't come to church. We couldn't come together with my husband, but he was coming. But then he came even when all those were close to come here, but he came. He was praying for you. When I say you, he was praying for us all, and we thank God because he had a star. He has enabled him to come this far. I'm well. I'm safe. The Lord is my savior. And I thank God because he has called us into his ministry to serve him at such a time when sometimes we fear, when sometimes there is darkness, but we thank him because he has our destiny. When I speak, this is a talent Sunday, and ladies, we have been here since Monday, and we are now climaxing our talent week. We started on Monday, and we came here for the vicar to have each launched. We were here and we were blessed. Women or ladies in the church were visiting the vicar, and they did so in the church. When I saw it, it was a unique one. Whenever COVID, we met a man and and we launched it in the church where ladies came to visit the vicar and his family. We were here and we were really blessed. We came also for a Bible study and studied the book of Acts, where we were talking about Tabitha. Because our theme this time, the theme for the mother's union, is got from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5. Fully carry out the ministry God has given you. So we were looking at how Tabitha used her talent. And I told the ladies who are here on Monday, I was challenged by my girl. She is in class 4. And I was explaining to them, now coming week, I would be coming to home early. Why? Because I'll be going to join the mothers in church because we have a talent week. And the girl looked at me and asked, now ma'am, what is your talent? At a time of 1.5 meters from your brother or your sister, who will say, what is your talent? Niliona kama nimeangukiwa. My dad asking me, ma'am, what is your talent? The other question was, sasa hata kama mnaenda, mtakuwa mnaleta talent zenu zote pamoja, itakuwaje? Itakuwaje mkileta, what is your talent? I can imagine if we all brought our talents together. Kwa sababu yeye anaamini wanafanya CBC, oh, please, we are going to mix Swahili and English and Kikuyu and whatever else God is going to make me use. What does it mean? No, alikuwa anafikiria itakuwaje if all ladies in the church brought their talents. It would be great. What does it mean? It would be great if all of us came with our talents. because of the Father. If all of us came with our talent to serve our Maker, to minister to everybody. On Tuesday, we came to church too, and we remembered the people who were affected during the COVID-19. Remember, there was a time it was too rainy and there were floods, and also people had lost their loved ones. It was a special ministry on Tuesday. We brought them together in church, we prayed together, we had a fellowship together, and we blessed them with what we had. On Wednesday then, we also came to church. People who were needy, we gave them clothes, we gave them food, and we prayed together and fellowshiped together. Because our thing is fully carry out the ministry that God has given you. So whatever we were doing, we were carrying out the ministry that God has put in us. The ministry that God has given us, we were using our talents. Perhaps we may not all come here in the pulpit to preach. We may not be there where the vicar and the clergy sit. We may not fit there. We may not all fit where the choir is. We may not all fit where the praise and worship is. But now we have to re-examine ourselves. Am I using my talent? Do I have a talent? And there is a Kikuyu singer who saying, I can buy the matire naika oisio neke wa hero negai. What is your talent? And how will it be if we use our talent and brought them in the house of the Father and we made use of them? Well, how would it be if we all came? Wewe unajua kufunza sana, come and teach. Wewe unajua kuhubiri sana, come and preach. Wewe unajua kazi nyingine nzuri sana, come and do it. We are bringing our talents as women. We may not all sing. Mwalimu hapa anajua kuweka zote zinaingia kwa key. Some say, yangu sauti hata haiwezi ingia kwa piano, hata haiwezi ingia, but you have a talent. All of us are gifted differently. Bwana asifiwe. On that day, we had a Bible study and we were talking about Hannah. And now we see when we are carrying out the ministry God has given us, there are some challenges, there are some setbacks. Kuna mambo ambayo yanatufanya we tusikaribie ama tusiweze kutumia vile vipawa vyetu. We looked at Hannah and we see she was the wife of Elkanah and a co-wife to Penina. Sometimes we look at Penina and say, this woman. But we say, it is good to have a Penina in our lives. One has to be because Penina made Hannah pray and pray ceaselessly. She prayed earnestly until she got what she wanted. And we thought, no, Hannah, this Penina had a place, had a key to play in Penina's life, in Hannah's life. While if not for her, perhaps Hannah would just sit and say, as long as my husband is giving me another portion of what I want, as long as my husband is saying he loves me, he is more than 7 sons, aketi na afike, pale alikuwa naenda, asende, so long as I have my husband, so long as I know I'm enough, I'm just aketi hapo tu. But Penina made her to pray. She would go and pour out her prayers to God. And one time, the priest saw her. Nakamwambia wewe mwanamke ulikunywa nini asubuhi? She was an object of mockery. She was an object of ridicule in the community because she had no son. She had no baby to call her own. But she prayed because of this. She did not have any son. And she prayed. She came to the house of God. She did it sacrificially. And she knew by the end of the day, my God liveth. One has liveth. She used her talent. She prayed and prayed. Until later, she got a baby boy. And this baby boy became a prophet in the land of Israel, a great one. She got somewhere, and later she was blessed with other babies. One has liveth. Because God did not relent to bless him. God was to bless her. God was very ready to bless her. On the eve, she prayed. So we have talents at a time. umetuongoza na wimbo. Take your candle, make it shine. Bwana asifiwe. Take your candle. There are so many programs today. Zinakuhitaji wewe. Zinanihitaji mimi. Wherever you are, unafikiria pengine mimi, hata kwa hiyo kanisa sionekani. Hata kwa hiyo kazi yetu sionekani. But you have a role to play. You have a role to play. Remember, there are so many girls and boys lying out there. For 7 months, they have been there. Wana watch TV, wanafanya mambo mengine, mengine anatukwaza. Mengine unashindwa, is this my son? Is this my girl? You have a role. What have you done? Ni kazi gani umefanya kwa hawa watoto? Ni nini umejitolea? At least to save a life. We have sung and said, a brother is in distress. A sister is dying out there because of stress, because of depression. What have you done? You are not a counselor. Yes, no, you are not. You are not a teacher. Yes, you can end up with a counselor. But what have you done? Have you used your talent? Wengi sana wamepotea. Wengi sana walifutwa kazi. Wengi sana wameumia. Lakini sisi, as long as kazi yetu inaendelea, as long as sisi hatukufunga kazi yetu, as long as mshahara unaingia, I just sit in the house and relax. No, it is not a time to relax. It is a time to pray and pray earnestly. We are being taught by Hannah. Hata kama alipitia magumu aje, she prayed and prayed until she got what she wanted. And later, she continued until I was telling the mothers when we came and talked about Hannah. She was used to cleaning her own plate and perhaps an aushaya, the husband. That, but now later, she was blessed. Lazima akihesabu sahani ni ngapi, ndio aweke watoto hawa wote. Kwa sababu baadaye, alibarikiwa na watoto wengine, awekine wengi. So, even when we get to reach to where we want, tukiomba na tupewe kile ambacho tunataka, we should not sit back. We should not just sit. We should continue. When I speak, use your talent. Haitaisha. When you learn someone's handle, yako haitazimika. When I speak, when you help that brother, when you help that sister, utakumbukiwa. When I speak. On Friday, there was an interactive session between the ladies. Unfortunately, I was not in. So I saw ladies commenting, while above Hakukuja, you've missed something. So just say perhaps, utatuambia ni nini mkisema. Walionekana wamefurahia. So if you missed, if you are a mother and you missed, if you are a lady there and you missed, it was a whole week of great experience. Bwana asifiwe. So now our theme, taken from the book of 2 Timothy, and it was written by Paul, and our Mother's Union president, she is with us today. And the whole of this week, amekuwa akituandikia. Read the whole of 2 Timothy. Read the whole book of Timothy. It was written by Paul. And do you remember, Paul was not in this ministry before. But when he met God in Damascus, he had a turning point. And this is where perhaps he realized, I have a talent. If we look at the Bible, many of the letters are written by Paul. So when he realized he had a talent, he used it fully. And now, this chapter, in this chapter 4 of 2 Timothy, Paul wrote it before his death. It is believed he wrote it before his death. And here, he's charging Timothy to be diligent. Though many will not bear sound doctrine. As it is today, many people do not want to hear about the gospel. They want to hear what they want. Bwana asifiwe. Wanataka waambiwe, you are going to prosper. You are going to prosper mpaka lini. And you are prospering in sin. This is not the good news that you are going to prosper. Mm-mm. First of all, we are sinners. We've gone astray. We must repent. Bwana asifiwe. So that God is going to have a place in us. The Holy Spirit is going to have a place in us so that we are able to carry out the ministry. Before we carry out the ministry, we have sinned. We have wronged God. So we must first repent ourselves so that we are going to be able to carry out the ministry God has given. given us. In verses 1 to verse 5, Paul says, people will grow weary of the plain gospel of Christ. Yes, they don't want to hear about the good news. They don't want to be charged. They don't want to be told to use their talents. They don't want to be told to help the poor. They don't want to be told to help the church grow. They want to be told they are going to prosper. You are making it. You are making it in your businesses. You are going to heaven, but first, repent your sins. One has appeared. And he wants Timothy that people are going to be greedy. People are going to be lovers of money. People are going to be lovers of their souls and of their body. And he's telling Timothy, be watchful and be ready to bear all the painful effect of your faithfulness. Those people who are faithful in the society, those people who are righteous in the society, these days, but those days, they were seen as wanajifanya sana. Wow, wanaenda mbinguni gani. Walikuwa wanaonekana wanajifanya sana. But Paul touched Timothy. Preach the gospel in and out of season. When I feel, use your talent. Make churches. Teach these people in and out of season. Despite what? Despite whether people are going to listen, wachana na wao. But make sure you preach the gospel in and out of season. In verse 6 to 8, Paul had kept the faith. Now here, he was ready to go. He said, I am just wearing out myself. He had kept the doctrines of the gospel, and this was great comfort to him. After all the pain, preaching the word of God, after being put